So we were supposed to have this like big snowstorm this weekend, and instead what we have is sun with not a cloud in the sky. And all we got was a small dusting of snow. And I'm really disappointed because I was promised 4 to 12 inches by Tuesday. And yep, instead we have spring. Hello everybody, it is Samantha. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day today. I'm here today to do my January favorites. So it's all of the things that I love in the month of January. It has been months since I've done a favorites video, so it's high time that I did one, and I am very excited to do so. I have a lot of like new things I've tried that I'm very excited about, and I can't wait to share them with you guys. I usually try to break these videos up into different categories. So we have like books and media, shows, that kind of a thing, and then beauty products, and then random stuff. So I'm gonna try and keep to that kind of a general theme. So the first thing I want to talk about is my favorite book from January, or a book series rather. And for this I'm choosing the Spellslinger series by Sebastian DeCastell. I finished this series in January, though I did read the first three books in December. And when I say finish the series itself is not actually done. There's one more book coming out this year. But I read all of the books between December and January, and it's one of my new favorite series. I love it so much. Is it just as good as his Greatcoat series, which I also really enjoyed, which is his adult series. The Spellslinger series is his YA fantasy story, and it's really, really good. It kind of has some steampunk western vibes to it, but it's really original. I love all the characters. It's not like your typical YA. There's not a ton of romance and things of that nature happening. There's a lot of action, there's a lot of humor, and I love everything about it. So this was a new favorite of mine for sure. So now moving into music, I have a couple of albums that I've really found myself enjoying the past month or so. The first one is John Bellion's newest album, which is Glory Sound Prep, and I really have actually been enjoying this album. I do like his other album, The Human Condition, a little bit more, but I still am enjoying his music. But I still do love this album. I don't know what it is about his music. It always just has a good beat and has wonderful lyrics, and so I always find myself really enjoying his stuff. The other artist that I've been enjoying the past month is Alice Merton. She finally released her first album, because previously she had just been releasing various EPs, and so she finally released an album, and it is so good. I love her music so much. So there's a few other artists and songs and whatnot that I have been enjoying, and I've actually compiled a whole 2019 playlist, so that's all the music that I'm kind of listening to right now. So I will leave a link to that Spotify playlist down below if you guys would like to check it out. And finally, in terms of TV shows, I of course have been loving Schitt's Creek. As you guys may know, Schitt's Creek season 5 is on air right now, and I actually purchased the season on Amazon because I could not wait for it to come on Netflix, because it doesn't come to the US Netflix until like October, and I don't want to wait that long. So I bought it on Amazon and I have no regrets. I love the show. It's hilarious. If you don't know what it is, it's a Canadian TV show that is written and produced by Eugene Levy and his son Dan Levy, and both star in the show as well. It's about this rich family that basically lost all of their money, and they're forced to move to this town called Schitt's Creek. The reason they have to move to this town is because Dad had purchased it as a joke because of the name, and it is the only asset they had that they still own. So they're forced to live in this town and kind of, you know, rebuild their life from there. It is hilarious. Catherine O'Hara plays the mom, Eugene Levy plays the dad, Dan Levy plays the son, David, and then there is the sister, Alexis, and the show is fantastic. Highly recommend it. A lot of humor, a lot of heartwarming moments, and the romance between David and Patrick is one of the best things ever. So I highly recommend checking out the show if you need a new show to watch. Plus, they're only like 20 minutes long, and they're funny, so it's a win-win. Moving into beauty products, I have quite a few that I want to talk about. So the first thing is actually something I've been enjoying the past few months, in fact. So if you've watched my Instagram, you will know I'm obsessed with these, and it is the Impress fake press-on nails. So I never used fake nails before because I always thought they were stupid. I don't know why, I just thought they would look tacky. But then I saw this other bigger British vlogger use these on her YouTube channel, and I'm like, actually those look kind of cool. So they're made with gel nail polish, and then when you put them on, they look like real nails. When I put them on, nobody knows I have fake nails on. People always compliment me on my nails because they think I just had them done. And it's great because when you're done, you can just kind of pop them off and then you're good to go. So I highly recommend checking out the Impress nails if you're like me and you kind of want like a low maintenance nail solution, because I like the look of like painted nails, but I hate painting my nails and I kind of suck at it. So these have been amazing, and there's so many different colors and designs and patterns, and I love them so much. This is one of the ones I'm actually gonna be putting on today. This is purple one. It has some mirrored accent nails, and they're a lot of fun. I will say that you should space out when you use them, because I was putting them on, getting tired of that design, popping them off and putting on new ones, and it does start to kind of hurt your nail a little bit after a while. So I recommend like having some space between applying these. But other than that, they have been fantastic, and I definitely recommend them if you're like me and you're lazy and you want pretty nails. The next item on here is a perfume. So I'm not a massive perfume user, but I do kind of, you know, I want a nice scent sometimes, you know, you want to smell good. But I have a hard time finding scents that I enjoy. But I finally found one at Sephora, and it is Daisy Dream by Marc Jacobs. This is just the little rollerball one that you can buy, because I didn't want to like commit to a full bottle of it. So it's just a little rollerball, and it has a really nice fresh floral scent. And for me, it's really hard for me to find scents that I actually like, but this one fit the bill. So the next beauty item is something that I cannot believe I have not tried before now, which will shock you given that I have curly hair, and it is the entire Deva curly hair line. The next beauty item is actually probably going to surprise you in the fact that I have not tried this until now. I don't know why I waited so long, but it is the Deva Curl products. So as you guys can tell, I have curly hair, and I finally decided to just give the Deva Curl stuff a shot because I have been eyeing it for a long time, and I finally decided to buy like a little set of travel size, like a little sample set that you can get at Sephora, and I fell in love with it. The stuff is amazing. My hair has actually been a lot more curly and hydrated, and so even when I go out in the wind, it doesn't really get messed up, because what I was using before, it would kind of make it a little bit frizzy and it would drive me nuts. This keeps the curl. It's amazing. The stuff is amazing. So it does take a little bit of trial and error in trying to figure out what products you need to use and how you need to use them for your hair. But the No Poo, for example, which is like their no sulfate free, silicone free shampoo, it works great. But I noticed I have to use a fair amount of product and really scrub it into my scalp, but and making sure I rinse thoroughly. But other than that, I get like really nice clean hair. Their conditioner is amazing. This is their curl cream. I use their Define and Control styling cream and their gel to do my hair in the morning and then just diffuse it dry, and it works like a dream. And their products last a long time. I'm going on almost 2 months with the shampoo, like a month and a half, and it's still half full, so it lasts a pretty long time. And so I definitely recommend checking it out if you are a curly girl like me. The next two beauty items I have been loving, I actually very nicely received for Christmas. And the first one is the Anastasia Sultry palette. I love the Anastasia eyeshadows. If you've followed my channel for a while, you'll know this. Their stuff is amazing. They go on like a dream. I really have been enjoying this palette. It's not quite as pigmented as some of the other palettes, and there's quite a few glittery shades which are a little bit more loosely packed, so do keep that in mind. But I still love the shades in this palette. It is full of a lot of neutrals and just really pretty, like that pretty coral color. So it has a lot of neutrals, browns, beige tones, and I really, really, really like it. It's really pretty. I love the Anastasia eyeshadows. What can I say? It's pretty much the only eyeshadows I use now. And the other item I have been loving has been a lifesaver. So I finally have a Clarisonic Mia. This is a face wash machine. It is these little brushes that there's a bunch of different heads you can use. This one is the one for sensitive skin, and you just turn it on like this, and then it will start circulating and vibrating. You put your face wash on it, and then you just go over your face. So this has been amazing. It has completely changed my skin game. So I would get a lot more frequent breakouts, and since I started using this, that has gone down considerably, and my face actually feels super, super clean. The other thing I noticed is I would always use, after I wash my face, the micellar water from Garnier, and whenever I would use it, there would always be some like residual makeup left on the sponge. I still use it after I wash my face with this, but there's no longer any residual makeup left on my face. Like, it gets everything off, and it's like a nice deep clean. So I definitely recommend checking this out if you're somebody like myself who has acne-prone skin. I also have combination skin, and it hasn't affected it at all. Sometimes I'll use stuff that'll kind of dry out my skin, and this has not done it. So it's been amazing. I love it. Okay, moving into kind of more random items, I have a couple of things I want to talk about. The first one is this unicorn Gigapet. So I was obsessed with Gigapets as a kid. They came out, I think, when I was in second or third grade. I wanted the dog so bad, and I got it that Christmas, and I loved it. It was so amazing. So they started releasing Gigapets again, and they have like these fantastical creatures, and my mom and dad know this about me, and they got me the unicorn one. So this is the little unicorn Gigapet who I need to attend to, because as you can see, all of his little icons are flashing right now. But it was so nostalgic to get this, and it works just like they used to as a kid. I had the dog and the frog, and now I have a unicorn. And maybe 30 years old, but I still love me a Gigapet. So the next thing I have to show you guys is actually an app. So I, as you guys may know, was trying bullet journaling last year, and I really, really enjoyed it, except for I would get frustrated because as somebody who doesn't really have very many artistic abilities, you want it to look like pretty and fun, like you see online, like you see these Instagrams of people's bullet journals that look so cool, but it gets a little frustrating when you can't do that because, you know, your handwriting's not the best and you can't draw. And I know it shouldn't matter, but I still wanted to make it look, you know, artistic and pretty and fun. And then I have a solution to that. And that solution is the Good Notes app. So I switched all of my notes, both for work and for my bullet journal, onto the Good Notes app. This thing is amazing. You can buy all these different sticker packs on Etsy that are only a couple of dollars. Like, this is one I bought that has snowflakes. And so I've moved all of my bullet journaling stuff onto this app, and it has been amazing. It's been great at work. I have the pen, so I can just handwrite onto the app with the Apple Pen, and that's been pretty, or the Apple Pencil rather, and that's been pretty cool. And so yeah, it's been amazing. It's been a game changer. I've actually been keeping up on it more than I used to. And I highly recommend it. If you're like me and you're artistically challenged, then I recommend checking out the Good Notes app because it's a lifesaver for people like us. And you can just go into Etsy and you can find so many different cool sticker packs you can buy, and then you can use the stickers in it, like you just, you know, add them to the page. And the Good Notes app recently updated, and they have some really new cool changes in the app, including more fonts. So there's more like handwritten type fonts, which is also pretty cool. So that has been a game changer for me this year. Okay, and the final thing I had to show in this favorites video is something that I don't know why it took me so long to try them, because I was very, very against these for a very, very long time. And I have now joined the, like, thousands of other people who have also started using these this year, and that is the Apple AirPods. So when I first saw these come out, I was so against them. I'm like, they look stupid. You're gonna look like a Cyberman from Doctor Who. This is how you get Cybermen. Like, who wants to do that? They probably sound stupid. They probably don't fit in my ears. But then I finally tried them, and they are a game changer. These things are amazing, and I'm never going back. Okay, so first of all, having wireless earbuds is an amazing experience. Second, the sound quality is fantastic. They sound just as good as my $100 pair of earbuds that I had that were wired. And third, they actually fit in my ears, which is amazing because usually the Apple earbuds, they don't fit. These do. They don't go anywhere. They sit in there. They're great. They're great for talking on the phone, so you can still hear like the ambient sounds going on around you, but you can also hear the person talking to you. I love them. So people are not lying when they say how great they are, because they really, really are fantastic. And if you are curious about checking them out, I highly recommend doing so. Though it sounds like they're actually going to be releasing a new version of these, so you might want to wait, because, you know, you buy them and then you're like, oh look, you guys just came out with new ones, so oops on me. But if you're looking into them, I definitely recommend checking them out because I have loved them so much. Alright guys, that is it for my January favorites video. I hope you guys enjoy seeing some of the things I have been loving the past month. If you guys have tried any of these things, I would love to know what you think about them and what your favorite thing was from the month of January. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day. Until next time, happy reading. Bye!